I will tell you how to become a pilot in Sri Lanka. So let's get started. So what are the steps that you need to follow before becoming a pilot? These are research, what are the basic requirements, and the third one is your training stages. As the name suggests, research is having a deep knowledge about a topic. So before becoming a pilot, you need to research on the topic that how to become a pilot and what are the roles and responsibilities and all that. What are the basic requirements that one should follow or one should have before becoming a pilot? These are, first is age. Your age should be a minimum of 17 years, so that you can receive a student pilot license, and after that you can have the other license as well, but the minimum is 17 years of age. What are the educational requirements? You need to have a pilot degree license. To have it, you need to have a school high degree certificate in aviation field mainly. And the third is language proficiency. You should be very fluent in speaking English and your native language. This is the basic and the most important requirement. The third one is, what are the stages that you should follow, that you need to go through before becoming a pilot? These are, first is student pilot license. This license will allow you to start your flight training, that how you will get into pilot training and how you will actually flight. The second one is private pilot license. This will allow you to fly your solo plane or a passenger one or a cargo, but this will not give you any sort of monetary benefit. The third one is commercial pilot license. This license will allow you to earn from flying to be paid as a professional pilot. This license will enable you to establish yourself as a commercial pilot one. Fourth is instrumental rating. Now, instrumental rating means that a pilot can fly a plane in any weather condition. It is either good or bad, it is raining or whatever. But he can fly in any of the situations. The fifth is multi-engine rating. Multi-engine rating is you can fly a different engine aircrafts. Now next is, what are the career options that are available for you as a pilot? These are, you can become an airline pilot for the large airlines or the smaller regional ones. The second is, you can fly a corporate plane or a business plane. Third is cargo pilot, then charter or air taxi pilot, then flight instructor, and the last but not the least is your medical or air ambulance pilot. Now, from where you can actually get your pilot training? So these are your flight school. You can go to any of the flight school where you can have the basic or the advanced knowledge of flight training as a pilot. The second is aviation related college degree program. Now this program will enable you to have all the knowledge of the aviation industry, that how to fly a plane, how to handle all the settings and what to do in emergency and all those things. The third one is Airline Cadet Pilot Program. This will enable you on how to actually fly a plane. Then you can join the military as well if you want to serve as a medical air pilot. Then you can join the military. Now, what are some tips that you should keep in mind while picking up a flight school? The first one is decide your own pilot goals. By deciding your pilot goals, you will know that which school is better for me according to my needs and my wants. The second one is determine how much you can afford to spend. Some colleges cost high and some low. If your budget allows you to go for a costlier college one, then you can go for it. If not, then you can also go for a low budget colleges. But see that they provide at least the essential training to you. The third is, how much free time do you have? This one says that how you can spend your time and how much you need to spend for attaining the minimum requirement or minimum knowledge. The fourth is, what equipments does the flight school use? Now, this is the very, very, very important point, because in flight training, you need to operate on all the equipments that are present there. So you should have the knowledge of every single equipment, be it small or a larger one. So you should keep in mind this objective, that school provides the basic knowledge on all the equipments, with the traditional ones and the advanced ones. The last is, visit your shortlist or flight school. This is also important in order to know that how the culture over there in the college is actually, how they train you, what are their practical expectations, and how much they give you practical knowledge. So this is also an important point. So that's it from my side. I hope you get an insight on how to become a pilot. Thank you.